Hello everyone, I hope you're blessed, experiencing the love and favor of the Lord, and that you're being fruitful wherever you are. Now, I'm going to talk about prayer. Prayer is spiritual warfare. Like, so many people never realize how much power we have as believers, as people that walk in the statutes of the Lord. But we have authority. We've been given this authority. We're the custodians of the land where we dwell. And this is a responsibility that is placed upon us as believers. And I mean, you can't be the light and you hide the light, you know. You have to use the light to shine it, to expose what's in the darkness. So I want to say this about prayer. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 18 verse 18, "Verily I say unto you, whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." You know, when you go, it is sad when you find a neighborhood that is filled with demons, like with demonic activity. And you find Christians there. And Christians are saying, hey, you have to move away from this neighborhood and go to another neighborhood. Right? Just because it feels unsafe, they decide to leave. Now, someone might say that, hey, I'm causing people to leave in certain conditions. Think of this as someone telling you, hey, don't get divorced. First try God. I mean, seek God, surrender to God and seek Him regarding it before you consider divorce. Think of it as that kind of situation. And another person in such a situation might come and say, hey, you're encouraging people to stay in violent marriages, you're encouraging people to stay in this, but if you say you're a Christian, this is what you have to consider. For you who was not a Christian, you can do whatever you want. You can leave that neighborhood, you can get divorced, you can enjoy your life, you can keep seeking the answers and truth. Perhaps you might come to God one day. You might come to Christ one day. So the thing is, I'm trying to give you an example of someone staying in a rough neighborhood. And this rough neighborhood is known to be drug infested, violent, death, gunshots, death by knives or whatever kinds of weapons. This is common in the world today. And then you find this Christian that stays in the neighborhood. Ever gone to such neighborhoods and find a Christian that has lived in such a neighborhood for a long time and they are safe? They have never been touched? That is one way God can protect you. That you're the custodian of the land, but this violence, this activity around you doesn't affect you. Like, God makes all this violence around you submit to you. It's at peace with you. Just like that proverb that says, a God will make your enemies be at peace with you. Let me try to seek that scripture and I give it to you. It's a proverb. Where is that? Sorry about that. God will make your enemies be at peace with you. verse. And it's Proverbs 16, 7. Let me go and read it in my Bible. Proverbs 16, 7. Proverbs 16, 7. Proverbs 16, 7. Give me a chance here, please. Proverbs 16, 7 says, "When a man's ways please the Lord, he will make even his enemies to be at peace with him." Isn't that amazing? You could live in the roughest neighborhoods, you could move around, but if your ways are pleasing to the Lord, you will be, your enemies will be at peace with you. It's not you to be at peace with them, because you're peaceful. It is them to be at peace with you. They'll seek this peace, they'll create this peace. And this is all biblical, so I'm not telling you guys crazy stuff that is just off my mind. That's why I'm pulling out scriptures. And going back to warfare, it is responsibility of a Christian to it's a responsibility of Christians to be the light and the salt of the world, to be the custodians of the land where they dwell. Like, you are supposed to pray for the neighborhood where you stay, for the city, for the country, for the county, for the home, for the building, or if you stay in an apartment building or a complex or something like that, you pray for that area. It is up to you, because you've been given the power to loose and to bind. And when you bind it here on the earth, and you say, this is my land, I dwell here, no spirit should come here and take any, you know, power, and you invite the Lord, you invite the Holy Spirit, you invite the blood of Jesus to cover that place. In fact, you grab the land, now it's yours. Like where I'm staying right now, I pray about this and I present this land to God and invite Him to be God over it. You understand? It is something we are supposed to do as Christians. So, for the most part, if you find people that say they're Christians and they're not doing this, and they live in impoverished neighborhoods, they live in violent neighborhoods, they're being affected, they're being robbed every now and then, they are not doing their work. First of all, they're not being the light. They're not being custodians, the custodians of the land that God has given to them, because you're supposed to claim the land where you go, and you're supposed to invite God to walk in that land, that very land where you dwell. You're supposed to invite God, God's presence. He will send His angels. You'll start seeing peace in the land where you dwell, you know? And the thing is that, for the most part, if you go back to the book of Genesis, God creates man and He puts man in charge of the garden. You know? And He commanded man He planted man in this garden and He told him, "Be fruitful." So, and I'm going to read from Genesis chapter 2 from verse 15. Genesis 2:15. "And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. He gifted him this world." This world is the Garden of Eden. For those of you that are seeking for physical Garden of, Garden of Eden, it is the world. This whole world is the Garden of Eden. And, you know, He gave him authority. He told him to dress it and to keep it. And this is what God is going to come back and say, "What did you do in the land? Did you keep it? Did you dress it?" And then you start looking, it's like, depart from me. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, to every tree of the garden thou may eat freely, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a help meet for him. So he created Adam and Eve. He created the wife, you know. And the whole encounter there, the account of Eve coming in and God commanding man to be fruitful. I'm trying to see where he says. I think it's in one. Yeah. Genesis chapter 1, 27-28. So God created man in his own image, and in the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. So we are supposed to have dominion over these things. And how do we have this dominion? We start by proclaiming it in prayer now. Because Christ came back and gave us this authority. We have to pray first. We have to take care of the animals around. We have to love. We have to cherish each and everything that is around us. And that brings God's presence to live around us, to dwell in us, you know? And it casts away evil, because those are works of light. To take care, to nurture, to love, to restore, to uplift. Those are works of light. To destroy, to be corrupt, to lie, those are works of darkness. If those works of darkness are in the land, darkness is going to dwell there. But when you do the works of light, proclaim, invite God to touch other hearts around, and you will see that happen. And I'm telling you guys, you start praying like this, you start calling God's presence, you start inviting God to take charge of your neighborhood. First of all, you pray for your household, you pray for your apartment building, you pray for your apartment or your house, then you pray for the apartment building, then you pray for your neighborhood. You know, or your neighborhood, then you pray for your whole suburb, then you pray for the town or the city where you are, the county or the municipality. So here we have municipalities. You pray for the municipality, then you pray for the city, then you pray for the whole state, then you pray for the nation. Then also you pray for your continent, like that. Because there you're sending out demons. Because when you pray and put in your city, you send them to other cities. They're gonna run to other cities. Then you cast them out from other cities, from the whole nation. Then they don't have anywhere to go. Then you cast them off the continent. They don't have anywhere to go. Then you cast them off the planet. You say in the whole world, all the continents. Then you cast them off the whole continent. You see that they have nowhere to go. Then you are, every day you do that, you are shaking the kingdom of darkness. All their plans are going to be shattered, and you have to proclaim and pray and invite the Lord Jesus Christ into this land, because we are the custodians. We do it here. I see the love of God here. I see love growing in this place. I see peace in this place. There's no crime in our neighborhood. There's no crime. Back in the day it had been there, but now there's none. Because we pray every day. Pray every day. As a Christian, this is part of your life. This is part of your walk. You're supposed to do this. You're not supposed to only pray, oh Lord, give me money. Oh Lord, I'm going through this. Pray for people around you. Pray for the city. Pray for the land. These people walk around in peace. They won't even know where it's coming from. It's coming from God. And you will be the custodian. And God, in his own way, he will bless you. And even if you're not blessed, even if you don't receive all these material things and the money and all that, when you die, God is gonna reward you, and he's gonna be grateful that you fought for others. Only a person that is willing to do that, That's the person that's going to make it in heaven. Because God is going to ask us for the works. Because if every man's works are burnt in the fire, that which is left is what will save the man. That is what will be your reward, you know. So if your works are not fruitful, if your works are of darkness, you're not going to make it. This is how we're supposed to love. You pray for the prisons. What's life, that's whatever is happening in the prisons. You pray for the churches. You have to pray for all these things. You pray for the churches so that all these false teachers, they leave your city. All the leaders, whether they leave the city or they truly come back, they return to Christ. And they start speaking the word of God, the truth to the people, you know. So don't be too harsh to them, you know, about it and cast them into hell and give them up. Present them to God so that he changes them. God will do that work. He will change them. If they fail, he'll punish them out of the land. God knows how to deal with them. So this is what we're supposed to do everywhere we go. Now, for example, I come from Uganda. I can't pray for Uganda now. I'm moved on. I'm past that. God took me out of that land. People in that land, let them deal with that land. He's brought me here to do works, to love people, to do everything. I have to start by doing it in my neighborhood, in my city. Then Uganda is supposed to be an extra work, or if God leads me. You understand? If God specifically instructs me. But the Christians in Uganda, they're supposed to be there. They're supposed to do that. It is the same thing. That's why we are everywhere. So that we keep the light going. So that we save more souls. I mean, we have to bring more souls to Christ so that they come to Christ and they see the truth. You know, so that they see the truth, and they are saved from hell. This is what we're supposed to do. Glory and honor be to God. Be blessed, guys. And I pray that this is a blessing to you, and you receive some kind of knowledge. Please pray every day. You cannot say that you have nothing to pray about. Stop these prayers of asking God for things every day. Ask God to heal you. Ask him once. Present it to him. Don't dwell on it all the time. Like next time, because you see, God will heal you, guys. I'm telling you. And it doesn't matter what kind of disease. It doesn't matter what kind of situation. I showed you the video with where he told Simon Peter to draw the net. And fish came out and Simon was submissive. You know, he had been fishing around the same area the whole night and there was nothing. And there comes this guy who doesn't even know anything about fish telling you to cast a net. And when he cast it, they caught so much fish that the nets got so filled, they caught another boat and the boat started sinking because there was too much that they had caught. So I want you to know one thing. Every after you make these prayers, believe that God has heard you. If you do not believe, you have wasted your time praying. Pray and present it to God and say, let me tell you, people don't have faith. I see it here in my neighborhood. I see it in this country. People do not have faith. People say, God, Jesus Christ. Yam, yam. People don't have faith. Jesus is just a lip service. And they are supposed to see Christ in you. So that you challenge them. And even if they do not accept Christ and they still stay in their faithless lives, when God is judging them at the end, he will show them that I had a servant there. I did great works through him. This guy spoke to you day and night, and now you haven't, you know, just like the rich man and Lazarus, you know. And that will be used against them in judgment, because God has presented everything. We talk about our lives, the very deep things in our lives that we're supposed to even keep like secret. We come and expose them, and we make ourselves naked before the world, because we're speaking the love of God, the truth, the power, you know, so that people come and trust God and surrender. But people still do not want. It is not going to go in vain. Do it. Keep doing it. Be a fool for Christ. Let people laugh at you, that you talk too much, that you speak strange things, you're paranoid, you're cuckoo. If they mock you, They are mocking God. They're not mocking you. They're mocking God. And when they come to him, he will use them for the same thing. The same people that used to mock you, they will be the loony ones preaching the word of God. So I pray that you're blessed and experience the love of God. I would encourage each and every one of you to have a prayer book. Have a prayer book where you write people's names, man. I recently went to a channel. What is the channel called? I think Wisdom and Knowledge, or Knowledge and Wisdom. There's a brother there. He's called Franklin. So he's American. I don't want to really do this, or as I mention people's channels. I'm not the kind to do that, or people's names still. But I'm just doing this because I'm just mentioning this because it was profound. I found this profound. He actually has a book. He actually also has a book where he wrote names. He has more pages than I, you know. So he writes his, you know, vertically. I write mine in a line, you know. So probably we have probably around the same number. But I saw that he also has a book. And he said that he prays every morning before noon. He prays for all these names individually. Me, I pray as a collective. I tell God, I present all the names to God. I don't pray, you know, but because the names are so many. But I pray and present the whole book. And sometimes when God speaks to me about someone and I present them, then I intercede for them, you know. But every day I also pray for my names in the book. Every time I pray, in the morning, in the evening. So, and it was so profound that he also had a book. I was like, wow, this is interesting, you know. So I advise that you guys out there, you also get a book. It doesn't hurt. Find people you pray for. You will be shocked when you meet these people in heaven and God tells you, prayers, they worked, you know. You are praying for this person, so why are you surprised to see them in the heavens, you know, something like that. So people need to be encouraged and do this. I pray that you're blessed. God bless you.